But let's start in the Palestinian territories. Within the past 24 hours, a series of developments have offered hope to the long besieged people of Gaza on the one hand, but also on the other, challenging the Palestinians' political leadership. President Trump used his State of the Union address to reiterate America's recognition of Jerusalem as Israel's capital. The State Department listed the political leader of Hamas, Ismail Haniyeh, a global terrorist, imposing sanctions on him. Meanwhile, Israel unveiled a billion-dollar plan to help ease Gaza's humanitarian crisis. And the European Union pledged an extra $53 million in aid to the Palestinians. Our correspondent Rosalind Jordan reports now from Washington.
The United States formally declared the Palestinian group Hamas a terrorist organization in 1997. 21 years later, Washington says Hamas's political chief, Ismail Haniyeh, is himself a specially designated global terrorist because, thanks to his leadership, Hamas has killed 17 Americans. The designation means that any assets Haniyeh has in the U.S. are now frozen. He can't travel there, and U.S. persons cannot give him any financial support. One official says Haniyeh is a clear threat to U.S. national security.
Haniyeh has been a member of Hamas since the 1980s, and he rose through the ranks in large part by continually championing terrorism against Israel. Haniyeh's calls for a renewed intifada just last month underscore how important today's designation is. We will not be distracted by Hamas's efforts to obscure its true and bloody nature.
Haniyeh called for a new uprising against Israel in December because of this.
We are no closer to a lasting peace agreement between Israel and the Palestinians.
The U.S. President Donald Trump's decision to recognize Jerusalem as the capital of Israel, something mandated by Congress, welcomed by the Israeli government, and condemned by Palestinians who want East Jerusalem to be the capital of their future nation. While Haniyeh attended a funeral for a Hamas member, his aides told reporters they don't take the U.S.'s move seriously.
It is clear that putting the name of Ismail Haniyeh on the terrorism list by the Americans came at a time that the U.S. administration is targeting Jerusalem. Putting sanctions and preventing the aid of the UNRWA, which is a continuation of the crimes against the Palestinian people.
Terrorism is not our style. We are not terrorists. It is forbidden in our Islam and our religion. For this reason, we are considering the statement of Trump as the foolish statement committed by people who know nothing about freedom fighters.
The U.S. says it will do all it can to stop Hamas from destabilizing the Middle East. The problem for the Trump administration, Hamas says it won't be deterred. Rosalind Jordan, Al Jazeera, Washington.
Well, we've been speaking to Basima Al-Ghussein, who's with the Truman National Security Project. She says Haniyeh's addition to the U.S. terror list comes as no surprise.
This is not a very significant policy change on the part of the United States because for many years, since the 1990s, Hamas as an organization has been already recognized as a terrorist organization by the United States. And so therefore, simply saying that the leader now is being singled out for individual designation as a terrorist is not a huge difference, although it will place individual sanctions on him as a person. Hamas has never been a party to the negotiating talks with the Israelis. It's always been with the Palestinian Authority. We don't recognize Hamas as a legitimate government entity, and so it doesn't quite accomplish any political end in a national security space. Again, it's just more a talking point added to the Trump administration's rhetoric that he's supposedly fighting back at terrorism. And today, the State Department officials' remarks specifically quoted Mr. Haniyeh's comments on another intifada. But I think it's important for English speakers to understand that the word intifada translates to uprising in English, and that was a direct response to President Donald Trump's decision to unilaterally recognize Jerusalem as the capital of Israel, which is exactly why U.S. national security experts for many years have warned against the United States unilaterally making this decision because it would precisely do that, foment tensions and increase risk for American citizens.
The European Union has pledged an extra $53 million for the Palestinians after the U.S. decision to withhold funding. The EU's foreign policy chief, Federica Mogherini, made the announcement at an emergency donors meeting in Brussels. Now, this comes after a UN warning that Gaza's economy is on the verge of collapse.